Hey, what's up everybody? This is Tony and welcome to Sketchflix. And today folks, yes folks, finally the Procreate 4.3 update is here and I want to do a little quick first impression video of what I think about all the new features in Procreate. Sketchflix is the channel where we do all things art, animation, weird challenges, stuff like that, and occasionally going forward I'd like to do some or art app reviews because look, I got this iPad Pro, I love it to death. And yeah, let's just get into it. So, what is new about Procreate 4.3? Well, from what I hear, there's a lot of new features, like now there's animated GIFs, text, a couple of new blending modes, and a new line smoothing tool. So all these I'd like to get into quite briefly, but let's just check it out. Let's see what they say. So here we go, they're talking about the new text. Cool, more of that please. Import fonts. You can now import fonts, people. So for me, I use a lot of custom fonts that I find or download off the internet. So this is really cool. Being able to bring in fonts that I like into Procreate is going to be really cool. Not to mention now I can do text. So I'm thinking I'll be making a lot of these comic things I want to do exclusively on Procreate. So share layers. I think this is a necessity for what they're trying to do with the animated apparently there's animated GIFs now or animation, so we'll get into that more. From what I hear, there's no onion skin or nothing like that. Kind of an important part of animation, but hey, what are you gonna do? Finer control, okay. And 7 extra blend modes. 7 new blend modes, that sounds really cool. The finer controls with the pen, that sounds really cool because I'm not a big fan of the current one. It gets kind of weird and noodly. I'll show you an example. All right, let's check it out. One of the new features in Procreate are these new blending modes. So here we have like the old drawing I did a couple weeks ago where I was just doing some messing around with some Fortnite stuff. So one of the layer blending modes that they've added is darker color. All right, let's get into it. Let's see. Okay, darker color. Apparently, what darker color does, it only shows colors that are darker than the layer below it. So let's say we have the yellow. It should only show colors that are darker than this yellow. So let's pick like kind of a purplish pink. Let's try it out. Interesting. So you can see here that only the things that are actually darker than the original color is showing up. So no, we'll try blue, but we're gonna try like a super light blue, right? And if that's the case, then the yellow, the banana should show. So let's give it a shot. Yep. Let's do like a different color so it shows out a little bit more. Let's do a green. We'll make it a green so you can really see it stand out. Because right now, you can kind of see the blue. Oops. But anyway, but you can see like how, now that I've switched to this color, could see it kind of pop through. Now this might be kind of cool for highlights and things like that. I don't know, not quite sure how I'd use it. Maybe it might be a good effect for with text or something. I don't know. So naturally the opposite of that blending mode would be lighter color. So much like before, and we're gonna choose lighten, so lighter color. Okay, so if we go up here in this corner, now we got kind of like a brownish orange kind of thing going on right here. So actually let's make it purple so you can really see it stand out. So if that's the case, if we do some painting in here, all these dark bits in here should turn purple. So wow, okay, cool. That I think I would use more than the other blend mode, to tell the truth. That's kind of cool. All right, so next up we got Vivid Light. So Vivid Light changes the color depending on the decreasing or the increasing of contrast of the color. So let's try another color. So let's try red, okay? We're gonna go back to here and we're gonna try, oh, there we go, Vivid Light. Hard to tell. Not sure what's going on here. Maybe if I change the color, it'll have more of an effect. Interesting. That's kind of cool. If the blend color is lighter or greater than 50% gray, it'll either lighten or darken the color. So some interesting colors here. This is a weird one, folks. I'm not 100% sure I'm gonna use this, but apparently it all depends on the threshold of it's either 50% lower or 50% higher than the blend color. And I guess you kind of mess around with that and see what you come up with. Let's just move on to something else. Okay, so the next one up is pin light. So let's give this a shot. So apparently pin light darkens and lightens the blending modes at the same time. What does that mean? I don't know. Let's check it out and see what it looks like. Maybe we go darker and see what happens here. All right, let's go lighter. I'm not quite sure what the application, how to use this effectively in a drawing, but try it out. All right, let's move on now to hard mix. Now, what does this do? No clue. Interesting. I don't know. But apparently, it works with using white or black or gray. So, depending on, like you see now, I'm using gray. It's giving me this weird thing going on here. I don't know what that's about, but yeah. I don't know. This is a weird one. This is crazy, dude. All right, let's keep moving. Alright folks, I think I've had my fill of these layer blending modes. I'm not 100% sure what's going on, but you can see a little bit like how you kind of mix and match and see what you can come up with. Alright, let's check out the text. Now, for me, text is a total game changer, so let's check it out. So how do you write text in this new version of Procreate? So, let's say we want our banana man saying something like, bananas. So, First off, you go to add, and you go down to text. Add text, and boom! There you have it, folks. You got text now, dog. So it's like, banana. And there we have it. We got text. So let's check out this edit style. So you can see here, you can have a bunch of different fonts you can choose from. All sorts of weird stuff you can do here. That's cool. Let's do impact. Bananas. You can also import your fonts. So that's right, folks. You can use all your custom fonts that you might have been collecting over all these years. So apparently you go to import font, and then you go into a file folder, and then you choose the file with all your fonts and stuff. You know, but I don't have any fonts loaded up. So anyway, let's check out some of these other features in here. So you got all your standard kind of functions within fonts of, like, you can adjust in size, you can do kerning, you know, you can tracking, leading, so you can do all that stuff right there. Baseline. Wow, cool. And opacity. Nice. So if you're not used to using fonts and stuff like that, it might be a little bit hard to understand what all these different functions do. That being said, if you are used to using fonts a lot, it's pretty straightforward. You know, you got, left justified, right justified, center. This is pretty straightforward. Awesome. And then you got like a thing for all caps. Cool. I didn't even know that. That's pretty dope. So you want to change. Okay. So if you want to stretch it out, you can. So you don't have to have that. It could have a different binding box. Now, something I just kind of ran into accidentally. Check this out, dude. If you click on this, you can go vertical orientation. That's awesome. I didn't know you could do that at first. So let's see, how do you change the color? So I guess once you have it selected, you can switch it to white. Cool, that's pretty straightforward. All right, so we have our text. Say you want to adjust it later. You're not happy with the font color. All you have to do is go back to the layer. Go to edit text, boom. You can edit it from there. So I can change the colors, I can do all this stuff again. And also, you can rasterize your layer, which is kind of good too. Wow, that's awesome. All right, Next up, let's check out some of this new line smoothing capability. So for me, I have shaky ass hands and I'm not really confident about my line work. And kind of a way to solve a shaky line work is to, one, use nice broad strokes for a new drawing, or use something like a line smoother. So in Procreate, before, for me to get around to do any sort of line smoothing, I would have to use something called Streamline. Now, I'm not a big fan about Streamline, and let me show you why. Because it feels like it's, you have like a noodle on a string, right? And I don't know about you, I don't like drawing this way. I like to have it kind of like nice and, you know, just smooth. So, but now we got, where is it? The pencil section, we got smoothing. So let me jack this up, and now I can have nice smooth strokes. And because, like I was saying before, because the iPad is a lot smaller screen, has a lot smaller screen real estate, when you're drawing something tight, it's really hard to get smooth lines because your hands tend to shake and I can't make big movements. And so now now I can do my sketches and have nice smooth lines because of the new smoothing ability. Wow, this is awesome. Holy crap. Yo, oh my God. People, if you're not using Procreate, let me tell you something. You are missing out because these cats are legit. They are knocking it out of the park. And I think Photoshop needs to start getting worried pretty soon because, look, I'm hardcore Photoshop all the way, but wow, they keep doing stuff like this. Honestly, Procreate has me right now because I can do text. I got line smoothing. I can do all the things I wanted to do. And it's all just here, you know? It's all here. I don't have to do anything. This is awesome. I'm kind of geeking out a little bit. This is really amazing. All right, animation. We can now do animation, which is kind of cool. I don't think there's an onion skinning thing, and that's kind of unfortunate. But let's check it out. All right, let's make a new layer. Let's do a nice round. Alright, let's make another layer. Reduce it. Do a makeshift onion skin. And do one more. And let's reduce this. So I guess doing something like this, I gotta set up multiple different colors for the different layers because otherwise it's gonna get confusing. That's okay. You know, we're learning here, so. All right, made a quick little sequence. How do we actually make this now into a animation? So, all right, let's see. All right, so we're gonna export this. Web ready. We go into albums. Let's see what it looks like. Oh, well, that's cool. All right, there you have it, folks. Those are some of the new features of the new Procreate 4.3 update. I have to say, I'm pretty impressed, people. They are really doing a good job keeping me away from using Photoshop all the time. This is good news, and I'm looking forward to future updates. So, that being said, listen, if you like this, please let me know if you want to see more things like this in the future with application reviews, whatnot. Please let me know. If you know somebody who likes this kind of content, please share it with them. It really helps the channel out and allows me to make more content like this for you. I'll get back to drawing stuff, but I just kind of wanted to talk about this update because it's really, really amazing. Yeah, I'm really happy about this. It's allowing me to get out there in the real world and act like a human for a change. So I'm really happy about this update. So yeah, folks, I guess that's it. So I will talk to you guys later. All right. Bye-bye.